Hello, welcome back. I'd start by saying we've got a review coming up, and it's a helicopter. Now, what I'm going to say is I'm a big supporter of our armed forces. I started out life in the Territorial Army, and I loved it. I joined for a joke, because they were just seen as like a dad's army type thing. It was all a big laugh. I soon found out that they went through exactly the same sort of training as the full-time soldiers, went on maneuvers, so on, so out on the gun range, all the same things, just over a longer period of time. And I loved it so much that inevitably I wanted to go into the full army. So anyway, unfortunately, not long after that, I had a dreadful sort of road traffic accident. I got multiple compound fractures down the left hand side of my body, and my army career was, I was medically discharged, and that was the end of that. So that just gives you some sort of idea why I am a big supporter of our armed forces. I really, really am a strong, staunch, I really believe they're the best, and I admire each and every one of them that becomes a soldier that fights for their country, whether they're in peacetime or whether they're gone to Afghanistan, Iraq, or whether they just served and they never went anywhere. When you take your oath of allegiance, you agree to do whatever. So, you know, I admire everyone for it. So whenever anything comes out that's to do with the armed forces, I always sort of buy it up, mainly books. I love to read the books about the soldiers, that their stories when they come back, about the bomb disposal dogs, about all sorts, you know, I read them all. And so this one came along recently in the Airfix sale, and I just read all about Operation Herrick in a book I was reading, and I believe the book was about I can't remember his name now, but it was, I can't remember their name, it's gonna bug me and all, but anyway, I'd read about this, and I just had to have it. So there was, I've added another couple of bits from the Operation Herrick range that I've built up and made, so they can't be reviewed now, unfortunately. But this one is still in its box, hasn't been opened. So I'm going to review it, and hopefully you're going to watch. Over to the bench. This really is a big kit, and I've had to move to the webcam above the desk because I just can't get it all in shot on the bridge camera. The bridge camera is too close, and if I move it further away, the box will look small compared to everything else. So overhead camera, you can see, this is quite a wide angle on my desk, and I can't, if I can get it up to the brushes. No, we need to come the other way. So if I push it to the edge of the desk, we've just got it in there. So we're on I think this is an A2 cutting mat. And my guess is it's almost as that size, not quite, but almost. And look at all this plastic we've got in here. We've got some bits falling off, which is not good. And it's in the same bag again, but there we go. They will learn one day. There's not a lot of information on the box. I missed doing the sides and back, but I will tell you, basically, there's just some information on the Augusta Westland Merlin HC3, and that's it really. And on the back, it's just on the back of the box, it's just information about the Airfix Club. There is nothing at all about the model or any other models really. It's just an advert for Airfix Club. Here we go. Let's do the decals quickly and get them out of the way. I'm guessing these will be cartographed because it's it will probably say on the box somewhere. I'm sure Airfix used cartograph. I haven't built an Airfix for quite some time, but they're very good. Very nice. Let me have a quick look. All in register. Yeah, can read all that. Colours are all lined up correctly. No sort of nothing out of place. It really is. I put the mouse mat underneath. It's just a waste of time, isn't it? Right, we'll give this a go again. But I'm not expecting. Oh, we might be in luck. I think, is it this one that's causing the problem? Yeah. Very nice. Very well. There's a lot there. A lot to go on. Let's move along. I've got a wire in the way, sorry. Union Jack there. I'm a very proud Brit. Royal Air Force. Nothing better. As the Americans will be with their Marines, and rightly so. You should support your own country. It's an important job they do, and we should be proud of them. Too many people don't appreciate their role. We've got an instruction. Oh, we've got a fold out. Oh, I like this. So we've got a big fold out edition with Hornby Hobbies, Westwood, Margate, Kent. And we've got so decals and paint colours and some decal placements. Camp Bastion, Helmand Province, Afghanistan, 2010. And they had a dangerous job, these pilots. I mean, some people would say that they're flying high out of the way, but no. You really should read some of the books and materials that come out. They really do a dangerous job, and they're in the line of fire all the time, the pilots. They do a superb job. This is a nice, they don't normally do this, not like this anyway. So I hope you're following through with it. We've got fuselage. Oh, we've got some interior detail then. Bulkhead, inside doorway, door. Oh, this is looking very nice. Airfix gets a bit of stick at times, but equally, when they do well, they do well. So here we go, we start off. Unfortunately, I can't really zoom in on this. Not on this setup anyway. Right. So basically, it's just the cockpit again going together first. And then this area at the back, interior applied decal here in that stage. Control columns going in, bulkheads going in, seats going in. It's strange. Do helicopter pilots not have ejector seats? Not sure. Do they not? Don't know. Maybe somebody can answer me that. Because obviously, I'm not a big pilot type person. I don't know these things. Then we've got more sort of interior detail placements. There's a side of the fuselage going on there, or the inner side. I think you get the inner sides, and then there's an outer side. We've got a ramp going in there. All the seats going along the side there that the that can be transport people about. And then we've got sort of a roof going on there, roof section. Don't really know what to say because I'm really out of my depth with helicopters. I was out of my depth with planes, but I've sort of learned as I've built them over the past year or so, I've started to recognise some of the pieces and some of the names. So it's a learning curve when you're doing these reviews. And this helicopter is probably one of my first of that type. So it is quite a learning curve. I know that these are exhausts here. And that looks like a turbine fan there. So we're getting there slowly. I've probably recognised the rotor column when it comes up. Rear stabilisers going on in this section down here. Can't really add any more than this, I'm afraid. Tyres, everyone can recognise tyres. Tyres going in. And it looks like they might be weighted. Yeah, it looks like they might be weighted. We'll have a look. Looks like there's going to be a lot of detail. It's going to be quite a long build. A few fiddly bits there, but I don't think anything that I'd be too worried about now. Had I opened this kit a year ago, I might have gone a bit white. We've got a machine gun at the end of the ramp there. It's to cover the soldiers as they're leaving and exiting and sort of getting on board, as it were. Here we've got the rotors going in and the rotor sections. It's going to be a nice bit of detail on that, especially when, and then finally the rotors. Is there an option to have them folded? I'm not too sure. I'm not too sure. So there we go. There's the instructions for those that wanted to know. Now we come to the kit. People moan about Airfix plastic, but I quite like it. Yeah, well, it's just me. I don't know, I like the colour. I think it's quite, it's soft. It's not too brittle. But here we go. So this is it, the Merlin. Oh, look at this. Look how big that is going to be when that's, I mean, you stand that there. Stand that and it's sorted there. We're looking at a kit that's going to be about that big. So, have you got something to put it in scale? I've got something to put it in scale. Somebody's pinched the ruler again. Anyway, so let's have a look at this close-up detail on here. Oh, that is fantastic. We've got some rivets there. Why is it when we review stuff, rivets is always one of the first things we mention? I'm going to bring this up to you. You've got to see some of this detail. It looks really nice. I don't see any flash on here at the moment.
And if you can see that rippling effect, that's like padding on the inside of the walls there, and that's a nice touch that they've done that. I think I'm sure it's this light that's causing the problem with the. There we go. And we've got what looks to be an access panel here, and over here it looks like they've got something that a control panel with, is that going to be switches or something in there? Amazing detail on that. Then we've got other things going on here. What's this here? Let me just tag you away a minute and have a close look. Straps, I think they're straps with for jumping out of, maybe. Then we've got an internal panel there, a floor or ceiling, I'm not sure. This is the floor, this side. Let me swivel that around so you can see the floor. Such a big sprue. That's the cockpit area, cockpit floor area here. Looks pretty plain at the moment, but rest assured it won't. And then the other side there. Let's just flip it over and I'm just going to check. We've got sink marks. I don't think they're going to be a problem at this stage. They're quite deep. They don't come through to the other side. Whether they're going to show when it's been built up, I'm going to say no. I'm going to give Airfix a benefit of the doubt and think that they've put them somewhere where they're not going to be seen and hope that I'm not made a fool out of later. So that's that first sprue. And you can tell how their plastic has changed from the plastic I reviewed when they made the Airfix, made the HMS Victory. It feels like a completely different plastic. It feels like a much, much better plastic. So it's obviously changed a lot over the years. We've got a lot of small pieces on this one. Let's come up. Just get a backing on there. Lots of small pieces on that sprue. I'm just going to flip it round like that so that everyone can get a. Let me just get that. Normally, when you do that, or that, you get a. Like that, it just focuses in so much better when that's out the way. We seem to get a much better lock on. Anyway, let me get back to the review because we were going well. Yeah, there we go. Some beautiful pieces there. Well moulded. Again, no flash that I can see. Just having a close look now. No broken pieces. We've got some very fragile pieces that are going to need careful dismantling and cleaning. And then we're looking on the opposite side. We've got some guns. There's the guns. Around about there, let me just. Just experimenting, sorry. Let me just try some. So there are the guns, just in the center there. Quite a nice size that'll take a nice wash. There's that sprue. So they're like your tiny pieces. You put that carefully down there, not going to damage it. Now we've got a big heavy sprue coming out. Although it's big and heavy, the pieces are quite small. So these obviously are the rotor, something to do with the rotor areas there. And here we've got the, you've got the turbo fans there. Let's use this. So we've got the turbo fans are here. I just want to bring that up a bit. There. And we've got the weighted wheels are there. Can we get that underneath? And what else can I say? There's a top rotor. This one. I haven't got a lot of room to move the sprue around. So I'm just looking out for points of interest that I can show you. Here we've got the rear rotor. Let me pull that back a bit. We've got the rear rotors here that go on the back arm there. And there's obviously two. And, you know, I don't think, have we seen the rotors yet? I don't think we have. Or have I totally walked past them? Or are these them? I was expecting them to be considerably longer. So that's that sprue. Just flip it over, look on the opposite side. No nasty surprises. The wheels are two piece, so there will be seam line to get rid of. But that's not very difficult at all. Unless you're a beginner, in which case there's plenty of information there on YouTube on how to do this. And we've got another sprue with all the seats and seat parts, it looks like. So these look to be all of your interior seats and parts. These are seats, I believe, and these are the backs of them, and they fold up. They'll fold up at the side. I don't see anything else there, really, that I can point out that I know. I'll just leave that up there a minute for you all to sort of look at. Flip that round so we can just see these edges here, what we've got. These, I think they're internal pieces as well. So we've just got a clear piece, but I don't, you know, I think I've just want to need to, before I do the clear piece, I just want to have a quick go through a couple of, back through a couple of these sprues and see where I put the rotors. Was that them that we saw? I think that's them, you know. Well, that's two of them. One. Oh, it's these. Yeah, my apologies. I thought they were internal details of some sort. They're not. They're rotors. I see that now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. They're all around the edge there. Nice detail on them. There's a little sort of recess lines on the top, and there's a little bit of recess line on the bottom. I don't know if you can see that. Come on, focus in for me. There we go. Oh, you did focus in. So there we go, those were the rotors. Very nice. So then, we've got this crystal parts left. Got a nice big front window. Completely missed the bag and just took a bit of the plastic off the end. I don't want to get any dirty mucky fingerprints on it. You know, it would have been much easier for me just to use the knife again. Oh, come on. Let's get that out of there. Otherwise it's just going to be a pain to put back in. Yes, that's... I can tell you that's nice. Yeah, that is very nice. Let me just look through it. And you can, yeah, there's no real distortion through the big piece. A little bit of sort of magnification through the smaller pieces, probably due to thickness, but then these wouldn't really be thin windows. They need to be sort of bulletproof, I guess, or at least ballistic, sort of, some sort of. Anyway, let's just give you a look at that. That is, you can just see that. That is a really nice finish on there, and they're really clear. I don't know, can you read the, see if we can position it so you can see the Ultimate logo through there. Oh. Obviously it'll warp slightly on the corners. There you go. Yes, very good. Very good job, Airfix, on that. I've got to say, I am impressed with what I've seen on this kit. So, Airfix kits are not all bad. At least I don't think so. They have knocked out some questionable stuff, but I think most of that is their older stuff. Which, let's face it, you know, a lot of things that you buy from years ago is not as good as the stuff you get now. But then the reverse is true also. A lot of stuff you got then, they do say they don't make it like they used to, and in some cases that's right. But when it comes to things like engineering, for example, you buy a car now, it's got far more refinement and power and workmanship gone into it than a car had 30 years ago. Anyway, we're drifting off the subject. So that's my review on the 148th Augusta Westland Merlin HC3 from the Operation Herrick. And I hope you enjoyed the review. I hope, like me, it's inspired you to go and build one and continue to support our forces whenever you get the chance. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll catch you all later. Bye for now.